we're picking up from where we left off in the last video. We changed the viewport layout, we did some housekeeping to clean up our 3D track and our scene, we selected all of our trackers and converted them to a mesh, which turned every solved tracker 3D position into a vertex, and we changed the color of the mesh. Now I'm going to show you how to build some proxy geometry using the vertices in our track mesh. If I don't have LiDAR or photogrammetry, I build reference geometry like this for every 3D track. It's critical to the QC process. But first, I want to discuss navigating in the perspective viewport. We have two perspective viewports because in the last video, we customized our viewports using the viewport layout manager. So let's use the perspective viewport in the lower left. We'll call that perspective B. And let's look at the mouse toolbar. As I discussed in the last video, you can click drag the first 7 of these to do the action their name describes. Click dragging look lets us look around the 3D scene without moving the position of our point of view. Orbit allows us to orbit around the scene. Dolly allows us to move forward and backward. Pan 2D and zoom allows us to pan and zoom the viewport in 2D. Click dragging scrub scrubs the playhead. Clicking render allows us to render previews, but we'll discuss that in greater depth later when we talk about QCing all our tracking work. Finally, lock locks the viewport to the camera we are 3D tracking. Now let's look at our preferences. Under Edit, Edit Preferences. In the search field, type Maya and click Search. This will bring up Enable Maya Style Navigation in Perspective. The balloon help tells us that checking this will make Alt Left, Alt Middle, and Alt Right orbit, pan, and dolly. If you like Maya Style Viewport Navigation, this is where you would set that up. Now that we've looked into how to get around the 3D viewport, let's get to building geometry. You can have many meshes in a SynthEyes scene, but this scene only contains one. TRK Mesh 01, or Track Mesh 1. Right now, Track Mesh 1 is the edit mesh. That just means Track Mesh 1 is set to have edits made at a vertex level. If you've ever taken an object and just about any 3D application and put it in edit mode, this is that. If Track Mesh 01 wasn't set as the edit mesh, we need to go to the mesh toolbar and then click Set Edit Mesh. You can also right-click in the viewport to either Set as Edit Mesh or Clear Edit Mesh. When we clear edit mesh, it looks like the mesh disappears, but it's still there. It's just that the vertices aren't being rendered because the mesh is not in edit mode. Setting Track Mesh 01 back to Edit Mesh makes the vertices visible again. The Set Edit Mesh button in the Mesh toolbar is a toggle. So you can use that to clear or to set the edit mesh. And finally, the keyboard shortcut M will also set and clear the edit mesh. Right now, our mesh is only made up of vertices, and to select vertices, so we can turn them into faces, we need to go to the very exciting Lasso Vertices button. Selecting vertices is easy. Holding down the left mouse button, just drag a lasso around the vertices you want to select. Adding to your selection is easy too. Just hold down the Shift key and lasso select more vertices. You can even shift-click on individual vertices to add them to the selection. Deselecting all those vertices is also simple. Just click in any empty space in the viewport. To deselect specific vertices is again also easy. Holding down the left mouse button and the Control key, just lasso the vertices you want deselected. You can even deselect individual vertices by directly Control-clicking on them. Okay, now that we've covered vertex selection, let's move on to the mysterious Triangulate tool. Let's lasso select the vertices on the face of the slope. Now let's click the triangulate button. Yikes, what happened? Well, when we lasso selected those vertices, we weren't being very careful. We not only grabbed the vertices on the face of the slope, we also grabbed all the vertices in the background. So let's undo that. Let's orbit around our selection. Now let's deselect all the vertices not on the face of the slope by holding down the control key and lassoing them. Using these selection and deselection tools, we can clean up and refine our selection even more and really get just the vertices on the face of the slope. Back in the camera perspective viewport, let's click triangulate again. That's better. But I want to show you something. Let's undo that triangulation and look at our selected vertices from perspective B. And let's orbit around to get a skewed view. Now let's triangulate from the skewed perspective B viewport. Take a mental picture of how this triangulation looks from the camera viewport. Now let's undo and triangulate from the camera perspective viewport. And again, from the perspective B viewport. What I'm trying to show you is that the triangulate tool uses the viewport point of view to calculate the triangulation. So you really want the viewport to be as perpendicular as possible to the vertices you want to triangulate. But triangulation can sometimes get ugly. Sometimes triangulate will give you some long, thin, ugly triangles around the edges of the patch you just triangulated. Let's clean those up. First, make sure lasso vertices is still selected. Now, select all the vertices that make up one of those long, thin triangles, and that face will be selected. Now, click delete selected faces. This will delete the face and leave the vertices. I encourage you to experiment with delete selected vertices at some point, but we don't want to do that here today. To delete triangles, you don't even need to lasso the vertices. If you click the center of any triangle, you'll select that face for easy deletion. That can be a lot faster than lassoing. Today, I'm happy to announce a new SynthEyes feature that's even faster for getting rid of those long, thin edge triangles. It's a script you can download right now. After you download it, just drop it right in your mesh script folder. It's called Select Bad Border Triangles. Let's run it and set the minimum angle to 5 degrees and the maximum angle to 170. Click the Select button. Then just click the Delete button. Nice. To extend this patch is just a matter of selecting more vertices, plus some on the edge of the patch, and then clicking Triangulate again. You may need to triangulate in patches to really get a decent mesh, but sometimes you may want more control. That's where Assemble Mesh comes in. Activate Assemble Mesh, and now you can quickly make triangles by just clicking vertices. Be sure you don't already have any vertices selected, and if you do, you can just Control-click to select your first vertex and ignore any previously selected vertices that might be off-screen or just occluded by geometry you already built. Then just click 1, 2, 3, triangle. You can build triangles pretty fast this way. If you want to start using Assemble Mesh with a new bunch of vertices, just remember to Control-click on the first vertex. When building geometry, Assemble Mesh gives you even more control over exactly how you want to lay out your mesh topology. There's something I feel needs to be said. SynthEyes is for 3D tracking, not complicated modeling. It doesn't have tools for sculpting or beveling or extruding faces. For that, you should really use your favorite modeling application. Back to the modeling tools that SynthEyes does have. All these tools are there to help you quickly lay out simple proxy geometry for your scene. Because building meshes can be meticulous and time-consuming, I'm not going to make you watch me model this whole canyon, but I built it using all the tools I just showed you. That about covers the basics of laying out proxy geometry in SynthEyes. Next, we're going to run our shot through a quality control check using the mesh that we just built. That way, we can prove all the 3D tracking work we just did is going to work for everyone else in the VFX pipeline. That is coming up in the next tutorial. Thanks for watching. This has been the latest installment of this series of intro tutorials for SynthEyes. Subscribe to this channel to be the first to watch future videos. And to learn more about SynthEyes, go to the Boris Effects website at borisfx.com.